Alright, so let's start off with our first investigation. This you probably already know, but we're just gonna go ahead and investigate it anyway. Okay, it says draw a triangle and label the sides with any measures. Let's draw a simple triangle. Franklin. 3, 4, and 5.
Where is this?
At the very beginning of your notes page, where it says investigation. Perimeter ratios. We're gonna investigate the perimeter ratios. Whenever we have similar figures, there's always a ratio. Sometimes if it gets 3 times bigger, it's 1 to 2. If it gets 3 times bigger, it's 1 to 3. Okay, we're gonna talk about the perimeter ratio. So it's calculating the perimeter. What's the perimeter of this? Okay, and it says multiply the dimension by scale factor and then draw the enlarged similar triangle. What do you all want the scale factor?
Two.
So scale factor is 2. So now you draw a larger right triangle. What are the measurements going to be? 6, 8, 10. Okay. So all of the side measures over here, all the side measures are going to get twice as large. Okay. Is that mean the perimeter is going to get twice as large?
Yes.
What's 6 plus 8 plus 10 plus 24? Yes, it did. It got 2 times larger. So you're going to hear me say side ratio a lot, okay? The side ratio is 1 to 2, going from left to right. Okay, if you go from right to left, it's 2 to 1. That is important, however it says. So here it actually says large to small. So we should technically write 2 to 1. Okay, this is large to small. Okay, 2 to 1. The perimeter ratio is the exact same thing as the side ratio. Okay, it's going to be 2 to 1 when large to small. If we go small to large, 1 to 2. Okay, so just keep that in mind. The perimeter is going to be the exact same as the side ratio. Easy. Alright, so the next one says find the exact circumference of these two circles in terms of pi. And then write the ratio of the circumferences from small to large. And then do the same with the radii. Okay, so the radii, the side ratio, I know it's not a side. Here you say side ratio. The radius ratio is what that's. 2 to 5. Okay, so this is the side ratio. So what's the perimeter ratio going to be? Or circumference ratio? 2 to 5 as well. Okay, so the side ratio and perimeter ratio are the exact same thing. That's what we just discovered. Okay, what's the circumference of that one? Y'all remember the formula? We did pi. Not pi r squared, that's the area. So what is it? 4 pi. Okay. Pi times diameter. Okay. So what is the bigger one going to be? Okay, so I know you can easily do that in your head. Look what happens when you reduce this ratio. 4 pi. So 10 pi, what happens to pi?
2 to 2.
It cancels out 2 to 5 when you reduce it. So see how it's the exact same thing? Okay, easy. So when we get into area, maybe we can do the same thing. Alright, so proportional perimeter conjecture. If the corresponding sidelengths of two similar polygons or the radii of two circles compared to the ratio A to B, what is going to be the perimeter ratio? A to B, the exact same thing, but we just said, discovered it twice, we did it on paper twice, and it came out the exact same. Alright, easy enough for perimeter. Let's move on to area now. Investigation two. Says draw a rectangle, label the sides with any measure. Alright, draw a small rectangle. So it's like on the side, one, two, and four. Alright, so the side lengths are two and four, opposite sides are congruent in a rectangle. Calculate the area, what's the area? Eight. Let's go units squared, okay, because we're in squared units now. Okay, draw another rectangle and choose a scale factor, we don't want the scale factor to be. There, two again, so let's use that same scale factor. And it's two, so draw a rectangle twice as big, what are your side lengths now? Four and eight, right, and it says find the area. The original area of the smaller one was eight, how come it ain't twice as big? Because everybody thinks that, and I'm sure the area is going to be twice as big. Why? Because we're in squared units, so it's actually four times bigger. What is four related to compared to my part of the Yes, two squared. So the area gets two squared times bigger. Okay? That's one of some of those problems that we kind of done already. I didn't let y'all change square units like feet into inches. Because all y'all were gonna do was divide by 12 or multiply by 12. Can't just multiply by 12 or divide by 12. You have to multiply or divide by 12 like squared. Okay? Whenever you're going from area, okay? Or using area. So write this down. The side ratio for this one was what? One to two. Okay. I know it says large to small. Okay. What's the perimeter ratio going to be? Same thing. Okay. Same as up. What's the area ratio going to be? Okay. One to four. Corresponding five sidelengths of two similar polygons, or the radii of two circles comparing the ratio A to B and their areas compared to. Square to B squared. Okay, so if you're ever going to solve for area, don't multiply it by its original scale factor, by its side ratio. Multiply it by its area ratio. Okay? Alright, let's try this problem here. So it says the area of that small one is 40 square inches, the side length is 5. What's the area of the larger one? And its side length is 7. These are right here, and they are similar. What's the side ratio, Randall? The side ratio. Five to seven. Going from left to right. Okay? 5 to 7. Connor, what's the area ratio? Square it, okay? So 3 squared is to 4 squared as Not nine. We want to figure out how much cheese is needed. 3 ounces. That goes with the smaller one or the larger one? Smaller one.
So where did you get 4 squared?
Well, we go to the side ratio to get the area ratio. The square, okay? Why do we have to use the squared ratio? Because we're dealing with area. You're covering, okay? Yeah, we use area ratio. The square is the 4 squared. And remember, 3 ounces covers the smaller one. We need to figure out how many ounces covers the larger one, right? Okay, so what do you multiply first? We get 4 squared and then divide by 3 squared. What do you get? 5 1/3 ounces is needed to cover the larger piece. Okay? Whenever it's dealing with covering or area, you gotta use the area ratio. Okay? So, 2 ratios really are focused on side ratio and area ratio. Not really perimeter ratio because that's the same as what? Side ratio. So, I'm not gonna really say that one a whole lot. Alright, last one. The ratio of the areas of 2 similar trapezoids is 1 to 9. So, what did they just give us? What did they give us? The area ratio. So write it down right now. Write it down. That is the area ratio. Right, writer. What is the ratio of the lengths of their altitudes? Anybody want to guess at that? Raise your hand. I'll just start it out. Anybody? Anybody? Wait, three. Okay, that obviously did not get twice as big. How many times bigger do you think it got?
Four.
How much bigger?
Eight.
Eight bigger. How does eight relate to that?
Two.
Two cubed. It got two cubed times bigger. So if all the sides get twice as big, the volume gonna get two cubed times bigger. What about the area, the surface area? How many times bigger is the surface area gonna get? Two squared times bigger, okay? So your side ratio here is one to two. Your surface area ratio is one to what? Two squared. Okay, it's really one squared to two squared. Always square both, because when you get like that 1, 5 to 7, then remember to square the 5 and the 7. And then the volume ratio is 1 cubed to 2 cubed. Okay? So it didn't get twice as big. That's why I didn't like y'all dividing 144 square inches by 12 to turn it into feet. Can't do that. Okay? Alright. Try it one more time. Okay, volume of the phone. What's the volume part of the phone? 1 1 4. 5 r squared times pi. There's no pi there, so what do we have to do? Use the back range here.
Yay.
So let's round to the 10th place. X squared minus 2 squared, and then take the square root. Should be quicker because that ring there should be a deal. 4, 4, what? 6. Alright, so I'm going to leave it in terms of pi. So what is 1 squared times 2 squared times 4.6? Let's multiply those three. 1 third you can easily put into your calculator. All of you now practicing, now can give it on the test coming up. If you're in any type of extracurricular activity, pretty sure your coach or your sponsor or whatever makes you practice before you go to competition, right? Okay, so practice, you don't practice it, you ain't gonna do good. You don't practice it in whatever sport or game you're playing, and you don't get into competition, right? What is that number, y'all? 61.13. Okay. All right, so that's the volume of the small one. Okay, what can I use the volume of the small one, Rainy? What do I use the volume of the small one to get the volume of the large? I don't want to go through and do the that right there. I don't want to do any of that. I don't want to do the formula. I can do something to that one right there to get that one. Take a guess. Don't blurt it out, people. I just cube it. Try to cube that. Okay, that is incorrect. What do I do to that number right there, Jordan? Something simple I can do to that number. He said cube it. Do you get the bottom of that one? That's about correct. What do I do to that number to get that one? Right, and instead of doing all of that, all I have to do is do one little thing. Multiply it by 4 cubed. Think about it. That's not 4 times bigger, right? So all you have to do to that to get the new volume is times it by 4 cubed. Not by 4, I guarantee you on the test coming up, a lot of y'all are going to multiply that by 4. Why? Because all the side ratios got 4 times bigger. And multiply it by 4, then multiply it by 4 cubed. And guess what? They're not going to give you all of this information like that in order you can just enter it into the formula. You're going to be missing stuff. You got to be able to do that. Okay? So they'll probably give you enough to get that or they may just give you that to begin with. Okay, this is the volume of that. Give me a volume of that one, or similar, okay? What is 6.13 times 4 cubed? Can one of y'all say it nice and loud and clear?
392.32.
Okay, so this is the volume of the larger. So, see, using the side ratio, cubic, we'll go from there, okay? Did everybody else get that? There are a lot of people that got that? And don't say yes, just say yes. Alright, so we'll go to this blank, if the side ratios are AB, what's the volume ratio gonna be? A cubed to B cubed, okay? Alright, last one, last example, has a little bit of everything. So you have two similar figures, they're trapezoidal prisms. The volume of the small one is 324 centimeters cubed. The surface area of the larger one is 300 centimeters cubed. And then they gave us this area of the base of the small prism to the area of the base of the large prism is 95. So what is this that they just gave us, based on the terminology that I've been telling you throughout this whole lesson? The area ratio, thank you, whoever said that. This is the area ratio, okay? There's three ratios that I talked about just a second ago. The side ratio, the area ratio, and the volume ratio. Don't really care to mention perimeter ratio, because it's the same as what? The side ratio, that one's easy, okay? Surface area ratio is the same as area ratio, because they're both in square units. Alright, so that's the area ratio. What is, Braden, little h to big h? What's that ratio going to be?
Side ratio.
Right? And in this case, it's going to be what? Use what they gave us.
Good. Why can't you go try to answer this own?
Yeah, dude. Come on. I'm trying to learn.
Okay, good. Don't say anything, Braden. Maddie, what's the side ratio? How'd you get that? You just square root 9, you just square root 25, that's it. 3 to 5. Okay? So, everybody understand how to get from area ratio to area. Now, what if they give us the volume ratio? How would you get from volume ratio to side ratio? Anybody know the answer? It's kind of like square root, a little different. Cube root, okay? So here's what a cube root looks like. Looks like that. See this little three right there? Okay? On your calculator, if you go to math, it's under the green button, you can see it. Okay? It's the fourth one down. That's a cube root. Okay? Don't get your own calculator. You should have got it from the beginning. Is that his, Olivia? No? Okay, your own calculator. Okay, see, all this whole time you have been practicing pretty much, that's how you're doing it. Alright, so if they give you the volume ratio, cube root to get the side ratio. So y'all might want to write that down. Volume to side ratio. Okay? Alright. What's the volume of the large prism to the volume of the small prism? Let's go with length. The volume of the large prism to the volume of the small prism. What is it? Make sense. Ratio, all you do is what? Cubic, that's it. wanna put that in your calculator and write 125 to 27, you can do that. So, I'll write that down. 125 to 27. That's what happens when you cube one out of two. Okay? Okay, so you can't go from area to here, you have to go from area to the side ratio and then from there to there. Okay? That's what Mason tried to do. He cubed that one instead of cubing that one. Okay? Just kind of write the line. Okay? Alright, last one. Second to last one. What's the volume of the large prism? Do you know the volume of the small one? Okay. What ratio do we need to use? We need to use this one, right? So let's write that down. 5 cubed is to 3 cubed. And what is to what, y'all? Very good. As x is to 324. Cross multiply, divide. There's your answer. Practice doing it in your calculator. What do you get there? 1500? And then a couple of y'all that got that? Okay. Alright, so 1500 units cubed. Or centimeters cubed. Alright, and then last one, find the surface area of the small one. Give me the proportion, the whole entire proportion, Tracy. Don't say anything. Proportion, I want to know what proportion to write down. Notice I wrote this proportion here to solve for that one. I want to write another proportion to solve for that one. Give me the proportion. By what? By the cube, incorrect. Okay, use your calculator. Get back to him. What'd you get last week?